Friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. This is one more interesting video on IoT, where we are going to explore how the IoT system works and its components. Let's get started and dive into the five main components that form the foundation of entire IoT ecosystem. These components are crucial for functioning of the IoT system. We will briefly discuss each component and then proceed to explore them in a great detail. The first component is sensors and actuators, which play a vital role in collecting and transmitting data to the next stage. Sensors and actuators are responsible for capturing physical input from the environment and transmitting it for further processing. Next, we have connectivity, which can be wired or wireless depending on the specific application requirements. Connectivity ensures seamless communication between devices within the IoT system. The third stage is IoT Cloud, which serves as a platform for storing and processing the collected data. The IoT Cloud plays a crucial role in managing and organizing the data effectively. Moving on, the fourth stage is IoT Analytics and Data Management. This stage involves the structuring of data into a useful format and performing analytics to gain valuable insight from the collected data. Lastly, we have the user interface, which enables user to monitor and control the IoT system. Through the user interface, user can interact with the system, receive information, and exercise control over connected devices. We will now proceed to explore each stage in detail, providing a comprehensive understanding of how these components work together in the IoT ecosystem. Now let's delve into the first stage, which encompasses sensors and actuators. First, we will focus on sensors. A sensor is a device that measures physical input from the surrounding environment and converts it into interpretable data for a computer or a controller. Depending on specific application, sensors can be either analog or digital. In IoT applications, there are various sensors that we can utilize. For instance, touch sensors enable touch-based interaction. Temperature sensors are used for measuring the temperature. Flow sensors to detect the flow rate of a substance, while position sensors determine the position of an object. Load cells are employed to measure the weight of an object, and gas sensors can detect gas leakage. Speed sensors, on the other hand, are utilized to measure speed. Lastly, sound sensors are employed to detect sound. All of these sensors serve as input devices, with some being digital and others analog. These sensors are typically integrated with microprocessor-based embedded systems, allowing them to collect data and connect to the internet. Advanced sensors have the capability to measure a wide range of complexities. In some IoT devices, multiple sensors are bundled together to collect diverse data and perform multiple functions. Take smartphones, for example, which incorporate sensors such as GPS, fingerprint scanners, tilt sensors, motion sensors, and various others into a single device. Thanks to technological advancements, sensors today are becoming increasingly compact, smart, and efficient. When selecting sensors, it's important to consider the specific purpose you aim to achieve. Factors such as accuracy, reliability of results, operational range, resolution, and the level of intelligence also influence the choice of sensors. Let's now turn our attention to actuators, which function in the opposite manner to sensors. While sensors sense and gather information, actuators take action and serve as the final control element. When they receive a signal or command, they initiate a specific action. Similar to sensors, actuators can be either analog or digital. There are several examples of actuators that we can explore. Motors, valves, pumps, LEDs, and speakers are some common examples. Motors, pumps, and LEDs are digital actuators, whereas valves and speakers are considered as analog actuators. It's worth noting that valves can be either analog or digital, depending on their design and functionality. Actuators are just as crucial as sensors in the IoT ecosystem. Once sensors detect a change in the environment, such as temperature variation, actuators play a vital role in initiating a response based on the trigger. The control signals for actuators can be either analog or digital, taking the form of voltage or current. Actuators may be required to turn something on or off, such as control valves that have significant values in industrial applications where precise control is necessary. Let's discuss the second component of IoT, which is connectivity and gateway. The first and foremost aspect to consider is the protocols that facilitate this connectivity. IoT protocols play a crucial role in enabling data transfer in online realm, ensuring secure and reliable connections between devices. Now, once the data is collected by sensors, it necessitates a mean of transportation. In simpler terms, a communication channel is essential between sensors and the cloud. In the realm of IoT, there exist a variety of communication protocols that are utilized based on factors such as range, power requirements, data rates, bandwidth, and cost. For instance, cellular, Bluetooth, Wi-Fi, and LoRaWAN are some of the commonly used protocols in the present era. These IoT standards and protocols form an invisible language enabling seamless communication between physical objects. Let us now delve into some of the IoT protocols in greater detail. The choice of protocol depends on the range of communication required. If the data needs to be transmitted within a distance of less than 300 feet, there are several protocols available such as Bluetooth, Zigbee, NFC and Wi-Fi. For communication over longer distances, up to 5 kilometers, cellular communication protocols like 2G, 3G, 4G and 5G can be utilized. These protocols enable data transmission over greater ranges. If the range needs to be extended even further and data is to be transmitted to the cloud within a distance of approximately 100 kilometers, there are specific communication protocols designed for such scenarios. Examples include LoRaWAN, Sigfox, and NB-IoT. There are just a few examples of the wide range of IoT protocols available. The selection of the appropriate protocol depends on the specific communication requirements and the desired range of transmission. Let's discuss IoT gateways, which serve as a crucial link between edge devices such as sensors, actuators, and other field devices and the cloud. These gateways act as a bridge, allowing incoming raw data from the sensors to pass through and reach to the cloud. The primary role of the gateway is to translate network protocols, ensuring smooth communication among all devices within the network. It also facilitates the efficient management of data traffic, streamlining the flow of information. In addition, gateways provide a layer of security, safeguarding the entire system from unauthorized access and malicious attacks. By employing the latest encryption technique, the data flowing through the gateway remains protected. Furthermore, gateways have the capability to pre-process sensor data before transmitting it to the cloud. This pre-processing step helps reduce the volume of data, minimizing the burden of handling large amount of information at the previous stage. Some intelligent gateways can even analyze and filter out irrelevant data, transmitting only the pertinent information to the cloud. This not only saves memory, but also optimizes data transfer. Overall, IoT gateways play a vital role in ensuring secure, efficient, and optimized communication between edge devices and the cloud, contributing to the overall effectiveness of IoT system. Now let's discuss the third component of IoT, which is the IoT cloud. While the IoT cloud may be optional for certain services, of course it holds a significant importance in this ecosystem. The IoT cloud plays a crucial role in processing and storing the data collected from the gateway. It serves as the decision-making hub capable of analyzing the data and determining the course of action. In time-sensitive applications like health and safety, whereas real-time concerns are critical and latency or we can say delay cannot be compromised, the IoT cloud acts as a brain of the IoT ecosystem, responsible for processing, commanding, and applying analytics to the collected data. While it may not be necessary for every IoT application, some prefer leveraging the cloud due to its high performance capabilities, massive scalability, and reduced operational cost. Alternatively, edge computing or fog computing can also be considered for local processing. Edge computing is preferred when there is a need for extensive data processing and storage on-site, closer to the source of data generation. Ultimately, the choice between utilizing the IoT cloud or opting for local processing depends on specific requirements of the application, considering factors such as performance, scalability, cost, and data processing needs. Let's explore the fourth interesting component of IoT, which is IoT Analytics and Data Management. This component is primarily focused on various data operations, including data extraction, data analytics, data aggregation, and data classification. Now, data serves as the fuel for any business survival and success. In other words, analytics plays a crucial role in transforming raw data into valuable insights that can drive decision-making process. Tasks such as data aggregation, data extraction, and classification are performed to extract meaningful insight from the raw data. These analytics can range from basic operations like analyzing if a room's temperature falls within an acceptable range to more complex scenarios such as predicting a car crash. Predictive analysis using deep learning models can be employed to derive valuable insights from the data, enabling trend prediction, proactive planning, and informed business decision making. Performing these analytics requires robust storage capabilities and intelligent computation to make sense of the data. Now, depending on the IoT architecture, such tasks can be hosted on the cloud, leveraging its storage capability and computational power. The ability to analyze and manage data effectively is crucial for extracting valuable insights that can drive business growth, improve operational efficiency, and enhance overall decision-making processes in the IoT ecosystem. So let's explore the fifth and the last component of IoT, which is user interface. The user interface enables end users to monitor and control field devices through various functionalities, such as notifications, alerts, remote control, and live trades. The processed information is presented to the end user through a user-friendly application, which can trigger alarms or send notifications via email or text messages. The application may also offer an interface for the user to send instructions back to the system, such as adjusting the temperature or providing water to plants based on moisture readings and more. Furthermore, the user interface may provide real-time feeds or display trends to keep the user informed and engaged. It aims to enhance the user experience by providing intuitive controls and visual representation of the data. We hope you found this video informative and enjoyable. If you have any further questions, feel free to ask. Thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Thank you.